Just quickly on populism. And in the very beginning, we actually thought about calling it In the Age of Trump, but we thought, you know, let's have it be a little bit.
Maybe he'll be indicted.
We actually did have that conversation early on. Maybe, you know, it'd be too late. But it was really that this was much more, it was about more than Trump. It was about a level of dissatisfaction that is, you can see globally, certainly in the US and in Europe, that's expressed in many different ways because of these transformative shifts over the last 40 years in terms of demography, technology, and globalization. Our thesis is that the same things that brought on populism, both populism of the right and the left, that those same structural transformations is why we have what we're calling new localism. It's why problems are now being solved in this way. So for us, populism, understandably, is about the expression of grievance, and there's lots of good reasons for grievance, including widening income inequality. New localism is about solutions,
yeah.
And we wanted to focus on solutions, and we saw around the country, this isn't just aspirational, this is about where how things are being solved, whether it's in Philadelphia or in Akron or in Pittsburgh, things are being solved locally in a different way.
And it's really back to the future, right?
It is, I mean, in that way, absolutely.
You know, the voluntary associations that de Tocqueville lauded
sure.
were
absolutely.
About the new local, the old localism,
yep.
Where you built a hospital because you needed a hospital.
That's right.